$5,000 challenge into Tesla stock. Let's go. $5,000 challenge. First, let me say that I'm not like some of these other YouTubers that says, you know, boastfully say, hey, I'm going to throw $5,000. Oh, I'm gonna put $300,000 in the Tesla tomorrow and pop it. I'm not that guy. For those of you that know me, what I like to do with this channel is to inform, help us all be better investors, right? And so I'm going to explain, I'm going to show you what the $5,000 Tesla challenge is, right? But I'm going to start off by making a statement from Warren Buffett, because it's going to explain everything. Warren Buffett once said that, he said this to investors, he wants investors to be fearful when others are greedy, right? And greedy when others are fearful. So you should be fearful when others are greedy, and greedy when others are fearful, right? And so think about what the lesson that I gave yesterday, which I'll provide a link down below. I explained to you about Snowflake and how hype was going to cause it to run all the way up. As a matter of fact, I took a bullet for you guys. I did a market order on the IPO of Snowflake, and I bought it for a whopping $300, right? Because that's what they do. If you do a market order, it's going to push it to its height and pop it. It's like the it's like the great poet Biggie said, dag, always trying to stick me from my papers. But anyway, you old heads know what that is. But listen, let's get to the challenge, the $5,000 challenge. So what I'm going to do is we're going to learn a couple of lessons. We're going to learn how to dollar cost average down, and we're going to also learn how to play on the hype, right? So a lot of people bought into the hype of Snowflake, right? And bought it at a high price. It's purely off of hype. The hype drove it up, right? But you can also make money on the hype. And here's what I mean. I don't want you guys to try it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to invest my own money up to $5,000, and I'm going to buy Tesla. Now, you're saying, so you're just going to buy Tesla. But here's the deal. Here's something that you're not realizing. And my friend Ron Lewis out there, what's up, buddy? He brought this to my attention, because I always look for dips. I always say buy on the dip. He brought this to my attention. If you look at Tesla every Friday, not just Tesla, most stocks, for those of you that don't know, during this period in the month of September, there's always a sell-off. There's always a sell-off. So Tesla, today is Thursday. Tomorrow, Tesla is going to have a sell-off. It's going to drop in price some period during the day. And it, you know, so this is what I'm thinking, because it did it this morning. It went down low, right? And because people were selling it off, and we know that Battery Day is coming Tuesday, right? Battery Day is the hype, for those of you that don't know, that Elon Musk has a, I said it correctly, he has a million mile battery. But there's been talk that they may not have it ready. They might just be announcing it, which will is kind of lackluster, right? The hype takes the air out of balloon when you just don't have the product. It's like Apple with the iPhone, right? But we knew it was pushed back to October. But here's what I'm going to do. I am going to buy Tesla, more Tesla. I'm gonna buy 10 to 12 shares, whatever 5,000 allows me to. I bought some on the dip this morning, and I'm gonna show it to you. I'm gonna show you part of my portfolio, and I'm gonna show it to you how I did it and how I dollar cost average down, right? So here's the whole deal in a nutshell. I'm gonna buy on the dip Friday when other people are selling off, profit taking. If this happens, that's when I'm gonna buy. Warren Buffett, be courageous when others are fearful. I know I'm paraphrasing. I forgot the quote just that fast. So I'm going to be aggressive while other people are selling off, right? I'm going to be brave while other people are being fearful. And so what he's saying is, and he said it in other words, when others are selling, you should be buying. And when others are buying, sometimes you should be selling, right? So people see a red in the stock and they go, something must be wrong with it. Let's dump it. But if it's a good company like Tesla, and if it's a long-term company like Tesla, Apple, Facebook, then you are actually doing better by buying it red because there's less volatility. So people buy up here when it's doing good and then they try to make money. If you buy down here when people sold off and they had a knee-jerk reaction, you're actually buying it at a better level because there's less volatility. You understand? There's more upside and downside. And you still, for those of you that purchase Snowflake or Tesla or Facebook or whatever, if you have it and you bought it a little high, it's a weight gain. It's not like it's a overnight company that's just going to go away tomorrow. Those companies are going to, those gold star companies, now these tech companies, but they're, to me, in my book, they're gold star tech companies. They're going to last. They're going to come out with new iPhones. They're going to come out with new cars. And let me tell you something else about battery day, because I like to give information. For those of you that don't know, if Tesla comes out with a battery that gets 1 million miles, it's a game changer. It is a total game changer. That means that the price of an EV, electric vehicle, is now more cost efficient than a gas combustion engine. So over the period of years now, and I think within 10 years, the gas combustion engine sales are going to do this, but the EVs are going to do this. And Tesla is an EV, electric vehicle. And at some point, the gas combustion engines, and I think in 10 years, you will not be able to go buy a new gas engine. It will all be electric vehicles. They are forced to come over because it makes sense for you to buy it. It's a better value. You're going to save the money on the fuel. That's what the whole deal is. I know a lot of people are not talking about this, but it is life-changing. And for you to get in on the technology on the ground floor, it is life-changing for you because there's a lot of money to be made. But back to the challenge, back to the matter at hand, old schoolers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you guys where I bought it at. I'm going to invest $5,000 in the Tesla. And I know for some of you guys, you're going, huh, I leave that for a tip. Okay, Big Willie. But then some of you guys, that's a nice piece of change, right? And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to buy that much Tesla between now and Friday. I'm really trying to look to buy more on the dip Friday when there is the sell-off. Every week they're selling Tesla off on a Friday because they don't want to run the risk of the weekend. That's why. Losing money. And then they buy back in. But you should be buying when it's red, not when it's green. And if you learn anything from Stock Up with Uncle Larry, you should learn that I'm going to always say, be patient. Don't buy in the FOMO, fear of missing out, and buy on the dip. You are a better investor buying on the dip. So let's look into my portfolio and let me show you what I did. Okay, you guys, as you can see here, Tesla, it is Thursday, September 17th. And this is part of my plan. Tesla is at 429 right now. I have 7 shares. I had 5 shares this morning. But as you could see, this morning, I bought 2 shares of Tesla at 417 exactly. And it filled at 416, actually. I put a limit order, I'm sorry, for 417. And it filled at 416.79, costing me an extra $833.58, right? But I also sold a share of Snowflakes. which I got snowed in at, and I sold it for $222. I bought it at $300. I'm showing you guys how to, if a stock You think a stock price is going to sit? Yeah, and that's I'm locking in that loss. But you're going to see what I do to Tesla to offset snow, right? So I'm going to show you guys. I call this buying on the hype. You got buying on the dip. I got this. I'm calling this buying on the hype. This is buying solely based on battery date. So what I plan on doing is making this 7 to 10 positions, right? So wherever it is Friday, which I believe is going to be a sell-off, then I am going to continue to double down or dollar cost average, right? And so far, my dollar cost average is 373 because I already had 5 shares at around 346 when I told you guys to buy the dip. Monday evening, I'm going to post another video and I'm going to show you what happened. Either I'm going to pop it Monday before the announcement is made and just lock in my wins, hopefully. Or if it is just a bull and it continue to run, I might leave it in. But I want to show you how you can do a quick grab of cash just based off of the hype. And I'm going to show you, had it been bad news or good news, where I could have sold it at and still made a profit. So you can make profits off the hype, right? And so here's the thing about Tesla. If it's all hype and the battery is not announced and it goes back down, I'm just stuck with Tesla. I'm not selling it. I'm going to wait. Tesla is a bull that keeps coming back. You can't stop that bull. It keeps coming back because there's more to come with Tesla. I can tell you right now, Tesla's working on an electric plane. Yep, an electric plane. It's going to happen. Elon Musk is a visionary, and that's why people invest in Tesla, not just because of electric cars. They're investing in his ability to be innovative. He continues to be innovative, and it's an innovative company, right? So that's what I'm going to do. Just like you said, just like you saw, I am going to continue to average cost, a dollar cost average down. So when it dips again, I'm going to buy more and I'm going to go up $5,000, how many shares that allows me to do. And I'm going to show you guys how to make money on the hype. Listen, this is what I want to do. I want you guys to do. I see you guys from all over the world. If you don't mind, leave a comment where you're from. Even states and cities, say what city and state you're from. And then if you're from out of country, state what country you're from. And here's another thing. We need more women getting this information. If you're a woman, let us know. Hey, we need more women out there making money. You know, there's a lot of single women out there, and I want to help as many people as I can be a smart, savvy investor and make money. And for those of you that have not subscribed yet and hit that notification bell, you're going to miss out on some great information. So remember, part two of this will be sometime Monday, hopefully, or post. The announcement is Tuesday. So Monday or Tuesday, I'm going to give you part two of this video. Then we're all going to learn from it, right? All right, y'all know what I'm going to ask you to do. Give that like button a finger, subscribe, hit that notification bell. Love you guys. We'll talk to you later. Peace.